Sources tell City News that a party here in Edson, 2 hours west of Edmonton, has sent, quote, a lot of Edson residents into Edmonton's already overwhelmed and full ICUs.
One person we spoke to outside of the hospital in town said she knew of a party happening outside of town 2 weeks ago that had sent some to the Edson Hospital. We're told a number of Edmonton ICU cases come from a party that was held in an attempt to get COVID-19 as a way to achieve natural herd immunity and produce antibodies, similar to chickenpox parties where children are intentionally exposed to the virus. Dr. Lauren Tyrell, a virology expert from the University of Alberta, says COVID-19 is much deadlier.
It's just unbelievable, and it's very sad and very irresponsible to think you would get good immunity from the virus without getting serious disease. And, you know, it carries a mortality rate of nearly around 2%, but also we've got all the long COVID people that have been infected and have symptoms for a longer period of time.
The idea of natural herd immunity has been prevalent recently. Albertan country singer Paul Brandt making headlines after he posted on social media that he didn't need to be vaccinated because he already had COVID-19. Brandt later tweeting that after conversations with medical experts, he reversed course on the decision. Dr. Tyrell tells me this kind of misinformation on immunity can lead to deadly consequences.
We thought originally that if we had 70 to 80% of people vaccinated, we'd slow up this pandemic. But with the Delta variant being more easily transmissible, we need to see herd immunity get closer to 90 or 93%.
City News reached out to Alberta Health Services for comment on the Edson party, Edson case numbers, and their concerns around intentionally contracting COVID-19. In a statement, newly appointed Alberta Health Minister Jason Copping says in part, quote, people who are hosting or attending these parties not only put themselves at risk of serious illness or death, but are adding stress to the healthcare system, which in turn may prevent other Albertans from getting the care they need. COVID-19 cases and hospitalizations continue to rise, largely in unvaccinated Albertans. Reporting from Edson, Darcy Ropchan, City News.